Hi folks, this is Ole de Vroet. I'm in the beautiful botanic garden of Marburg in Germany. And this here is a really colorful Fusalis species. Actually, the funny thing is this is the only Fusalis species which has traditionally been cultivated in Germany, despite the fact that it's not edible. So they cultivated this non-edible species for centuries, but not the nice edible golden berries. Well, why did they cultivate it? When I was younger, the book said that it's actually toxic, but they ate it a couple times because they confused it with golden berry. So you can actually survive a couple fruit, but don't eat too much. Here there is a sign, nicht essbar, non edible. They don't have such signs at the edible golden berries or tomatillos, which are in the same genus as this. Well, this, I don't have internet here, so I cannot Google what it was used for. It was used as some type of medicine, I remember. Also, it was used as an ornamental. When you dry the stalks, those calyxes around the fruit actually kind of retain their color, and so you can, have them as ornamental dry flowers. Yeah, I don't think it was used to poison anything because it's not that poisonous. It was also not regarded very highly. It was called Jewish cherry. And everything that was named after the Jews in Germany, you can basically consider it being of low quality because otherwise they wouldn't have named it after the Jews. So, let's try this non-edible Fusalis peruviana from Peru, by the way, I guess. So, the fruit inside is also very colorful. A lot more beautiful than all those edible golden berries and tomatillos and other stuff. The taste is also not so bad. A little bit sour, a little bit sweet. Sometimes it has a hint of bitterness. But yeah, basically, if it wasn't toxic, and I'm still not sure that all the scientists have agreed on whether it's toxic, if it wasn't toxic, you could actually use it for food. Yeah. Not too bad, this Fusalis peruviana, but obviously you are not supposed to eat it because it has too many toxins, so hands off the Fusalis peruviana. Also, folks, please don't start picking stuff in the botanic garden of Marburg. I have a permit to do this. That's why I'm walking around and picking a few fruit for my videos. But if you come to the botanic garden of Marburg, just watch the stuff without picking it. So, folks, stay tuned for a ton more tasty fruit videos from the beautiful botanic garden of Marburg. And if you want to support the channel, don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe.